Bowman break case. Bowman 2021 Bowman hobby case. Full case break. Number two. Number two. So here we go. Yeah, R2. I might, we might do that. Who knows? Oh man, I'm preaching the prisoner. Yeah, R2, me too. I would like to, I would love to see them get a nice win here and there once in a while. I don't think we're going to be that good this year still, but I think we're doing the right things, hopefully. Right in the right step, so. That's all I can ask for. But regardless, it's a lot of fun. There's a big group of us that go to all the games and stuff like that. We usually go to one away game a year. So. I know, Brian, I know.
They give you the skip the paper reminder.
Oh, yeah, and he's already, He's already, like, have Justin help him rip tires and all that stuff.
Oh, yeah. It's.
One of those Bowman guys.
He's like Ricky Bowman.
I think he told me to grow two extra hands one day.
Classic.
This is the devil. Wow, what's the rush, man?
Wants to know what's in there. Yes, I was going to break tonight. And he's on the west coast. So, he's got.
It's early,
that he knows that when it's midnight and it's 3 o'clock here, we're going to want to go home. He just didn't want to go.
Good old hobby boxes. I usually have pretty good luck with these hobbies, so hopefully we carry that tradition.
That last case was pretty good.
That last case was phenomenal, actually. After going through it again today. It was really good. Very good.
Finger Hut is back.
What's a Finger Hut?
It's an old store where you, like, I think they invented layaway.
I thought that was Kmart.
They sent out, like, magazines every month. Oh, this, it was just. It's a nostalgic thing. You're a bit young for it, I guess.
Here we go. There's Spotto.
Chase had an
Nice little ice for Tristan Gus's.
They do have to be, but I want to make sure for yeah.
Can I interrupt you for a moment?
Yeah, what's up?
These were on the wood sorting table next to the large flat rates, or are these the paper?
Yep. Because were all those other ones paper?
Yeah, but these are for a different person.
Oh, okay. Yep, they are from today. Austin Martin. Hey, Brian. No, different one. No, you're good. I was just saying Brian's going to, he said he was going to bed. Hasta mañana. Ooh, first auto, Nick Mattin. Ice. The Phillies. Out of 100. Robert Paulson out of $4.99. Nice. Brett Beatty for the Mets.
In the whole building were tied to that one computer that you do everything off of it.
Just, huh. You probably fry that hard drive pretty quick though. Depending on how many monitors.
I don't think we'd need one. We don't really save anything. Everything's
cloud.
Anything we save is like cloud based.
True.
Any like or videos that we download or record, they are deleted after uploaded to YouTube. I don't know. I got enough stuff I'm trying to figure out right now. I'm gonna add that sucker to it.
I wouldn't know how to do that either.
I'm in this thought process now of trying to figure out how to incorporate a podcast and a group link together. Where it looks good and runs smoothly.
Yeah, that would be cool. Like, have it in the window. Like, one of the windows. Like, with someone talking while someone's ripping.
Yeah.
The way you do it is you just set up another camera. So you know how you have that little window, like, introducing or what's ripping next? You would just throw another camera in there.
Yeah.
And you can have it set up anywhere, because I've seen that.
That's one of the things that I said to Jonathan.
Yeah.
But
do you see that sick LeBron Jimmy sent him?
Oh
Jimmy told me he sent him something big, and I didn't even want to ask what it was. And
yeah,
nice.
$100,000 There you go. You can have this.
Then I saw
it. I
like it. I saw it today. I was like, holy.
Literally.
You see the thing I sent you?
I haven't looked at anything yet.
I think you'll like it. I think it'll interest you.
Okay, let's keep hearing a minute. I gotta
no rush.
Set up this next rig. Yeah. The only thing I don't like about hobby is how much longer it is. It's like an extra half an hour.
Yeah. It's just the
which
path.
Is fine if it's you're doing it for yourself, but when you're doing it for like 30 other people at the same time, it's like,
that's why the jumbos.
Sorry, I can't make it go any faster.
I think that's why they made the jumbos is for group breaks.
Maybe.
So I feel like
when did they start doing that?
I don't remember that as a kid. I just always remember hobby. Like, packs were always like this.
Always.
And then they started going bigger, and I think that's because of the group breaks. Like, they adjusted. They adjusted for it. But who knows? Merrifield.
Quit.
Well, Nolan Gorman out of 199.
Do you think Wit is short for something?
Maybe. Wit. Like Whitney?
Maybe. Whitfield, is that a thing?
Whitfield?
Whitfield.
Sabota base. Boom. Orange.
No way. You caught this guy, or you caught him, dude.
I got more on it too. So then. little Tristan Cassis orange to 20.
Orange!
To 25. Boston. A little green for Anthony Volpe for the Yanks out of 399. Austin Martin.
Dude, Kevin Porter Jr. is a freak.
Yeah, dude.
Every time he gets in trouble, it's the dumbest thing you could do. And then he turns around and drops a career high.
He's only 20 years old, too.
No, you gotta give him a slap. So what? He went to a strip club and he threw a bowl of soup. Like, get over it. He's not that bad of a guy.
He's young with, you know, with all this fame and all that. Like, he'll grow up, but he can ball. He can ball. Should see the stack I had at my house of him, a Bowman era prism of him. Probably close to 100. I don't know when I should sell it. I sold some, all the ones I had at Star Style, but I don't know when I want to sell the ones I actually have in my possession. Here we go. Box number 3. I see how you set up the computer. I like it.
What's that?
With the windows. With the, like, show the orders and everything below the.
Oh, yeah.
Makes it easy. awesome. Thank you.
Futurism.
You like those ones?
Well, no, I'm going to end up
taking pictures of them.
Doing some Photoshops for us.
Oh, man. Oh.
We're all going to be futurists.
Uh-oh.
Figure that out.
A little yellow sparkle of Jeremy Pena for the Astros out of 75. Ooh, in the auto. Angel Martinez for the Indians. Sparkle. Out of 299. That's nice. Magenta for the Colorado Rockies. 299. If you're still on, hopefully we can get you some Rays here, some Mets. I know you and your dad, you guys get autographs, don't you, at the games? You'll probably be watching this tomorrow on replay. Yes, yeah, nice autos. There it is. The Wander action. Did I show the teams to start? I'm not sure if I did. I had the spreadsheet next to me. You have I don't know if I Jeez. Go Beats. Yusnel Diaz with the Orioles.
This picture of you, Justin.
It's hilarious.
I don't think anybody else caught it.
Probably a lot of people are asleep in our group chat.
Weak. We're the breaking division. We wake. We woke.
Yeah.
Oh my word, I want that card.
Which one?
The color glass of Trevor Lawrence.
Oh, yeah, that's.
One he has a Jaguar.
Dude, the Clemson one's even going to go for nuts because there's so many loyalists for Clemson. Yeah. It's going to be nuts. Dude, the color blasts are so awesome. I hit one in when I was in the shop for Prism Soccer. And I forgot how just awesome they are in person. Like, they are just so cool looking.
Those things are, in football, I know they're, like, super rare. One in every, like, 20 to 10 cases or something.
Yeah, that's how it is for all the sports, though. Like, they keep them. They do well with not over, like, the, too many of them. Have you seen Downtown?
Yeah.
Do you like those?
I do. I just don't think they're as rare as some of the other ones.
Yeah, they're not as rare, but they're...
I remember 2018 Domino's Optic, I was pulling them out of, like, every box. And now they're everybody treating them like they're...
Yeah.
SSPs.
I like the Tom Brady one when it has the Super Bowl numerals on it. I forget which one. I think that one's really cool. And I think Luca has like a panther or something on his.
I used to have one with Jalen Ramsey on it, and I had to sell it because it just brought me sadness to my heart.
Yeah, dude, he's so good.
I know. And he was an F. He was played for the Seminoles, so like I.
So you're a Seminoles fan?
Yeah.
Dude, I got something that you're gonna go nuts for.
Does it involve Bobby?
No. It's something that you probably won't, like, you don't even know that it exists, but I've had it for so long, and I've been waiting for someone that's, like, an actual Florida State fan that likes cards.
Burt Reynolds?
It's not a card. But it's something, it's going to go nice on the wall you're making.
Nice.
I'm telling you right now, you're going to go nuts. Because they're actually pretty rare to get.
Well... my excited voice.
I'll bring it tomorrow.
Man, if you ever go to a collegiate game where the Seminoles are playing at home and you hear the war chant, like 90,000 people, it's something else.
Yeah.
Yes.
They offered me a job to coach for on the baseball team in 2015. I went there and I stayed for a week. I was 22 years old at the time. Yeah, I would have went to school there if I would have known about it when I was younger. That place is fun.
It is fun. I've had many fun weekends there.
Went to Publix for old crab legs.
I've been to that Publix. There's so many, like, when I went there, I mean, there's just so many items in Publix.
It's a fun place.
Are you looking for the juice?
Look at this. To start it off, look at the auto. Alexander Vargas for the Yanks.
That is one hot auto.
You know, I missed the whole thing. I don't know what you're talking about, but I heard the tail end. Like, if you're on doing that or something like that, even if you don't have the intent to keep going, the chat is booked, you get going. It's good to drive engagement.
Just hot chicks.
San Francisco. Chicago. I don't remember. Oh, New England. Jesus.
And then Pittsburgh.
And then Pittsburgh's.
And the Lions drafted a lineman, which is good because. Riley Green. Look at that. To 125.
It's like a mix between Darnold and Johnny Manziel.
This guy looks like he's going to be a church group or something.
I know what you're talking about. He looks like he's walking around the
desert, but I can't put my finger on what he picked.
I think we're all loopy, dude.
Roadshow breaks after dark.
We start when it's dark.
Yeah.
That's always one.
Kyle Pitts fourth to Atlanta?
That's just crazy. Tight end, dude. They must have saw something.
The Bengals are already hot. Joe Burrow's coming back. Now they get Jamar Chase. That's huge. Alabama gets, or Miami gets a wide receiver. That's huge for Tua.
Yeah. It's going to be nuts, the next year's product.
I just don't know anything about Devonta Smith, the Alabama receiver that was taken at 10.
Oh, he's a beast, dude. He's just small.
He's just a gamer.
Like. Well, when they played Ohio State, all they did was all they did was throw the ball to the other kid.
Still got his numbers though, I think.
I'm talking about Jalen Waddle, but I don't know much about. I know a whole lot about Devonta Smith.
It's because Jalen Waddle was hurt most of the season, but he's a speedster. Like he's like a Tyreek Hill.
ETN to Jacksonville hurts a little.
Yep. It's like doubling on something that doesn't need to be doubled.
SmackDown.
What?
What's that?
No.
What is SmackDown?
No. What? Do you know
if they have Ric Flair in this?
Do you know 30 wrestling fans that will buy cards?
Hey, I'm sure there's 30 for $250.
Somewhere in the world.
Yeah, but do you know them? Dude, the people want to wait for months and months to find them.
The people didn't even take them for free yesterday.
What? Oh, yeah.
The top's finest.
We can't even have someone steal that from us. Okay. You're already here. Can you just take this?
You're already here.
Striking signatures. And Joe Montana collection would have been great to be there. I'm still waiting to see the video they did with the playbook box.
Oh, you gotta watch it. It's funny.
Did they send it?
Yeah, it's on the
I haven't been keeping up with the threads.
There is tons, dude. No, it's not on the text. It's on the, he posted it.
Oh, on the Instagram?
Yeah. There was tons of posts today. So yeah, it kind of got caught up, but it's funny. You'll enjoy it. The comments are great. There's this, I forget what the app is, but you can get like 5-10% back or whatever for all your top purchases as well. And that stuff adds up.
I got some Otani rookies.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
That's cool. got these.
Does anyone believe this Aaron Rodgers story?
I don't.
I don't either. I think it's draft type BS, like misdirection type of stuff.
Yep, because they just happened to do it right, like, hours before the draft.
Yeah, and there were just way too many people with information that they should never have had. Like, the Aaron Rodgers doesn't like anyone in the front office.
Yeah, that's a lot.
Like, that, come on.
It's funny because they asked Goodell about it live, and he goes, "I've been hearing about it every other day. So, like, what is the new news? Oh, it's probably the same as the last every other day." I was like, "Oh, geez."
I wish they'd trade Aaron Rodgers. So, like, I don't know. Somewhere, Cleveland?
Somewhere far away.
Very, very, very far away.
At one time, I was like, dude, watch. He's going to go to the Cowboys somehow. Oh, like, before be Dak signed.
You know, it would be even greater if he went to the AFC.
We already took Tom Brady. Oh, wait, no, we gave Tom Brady.
Ooh, this is a cool color match. Ace of Lacy, blue. To 150. Ace of Lacy, neon green. $3.99.
They're gonna follow an Alphonse card. Right. Sure.
I just used to go to Costco.
Is there a Costco around here?
Yeah.
Is there?
Orange. Look at this, Brian.
What do you got?
Nick Madrigal, orange, auto /25, little White Sox action.
No That's way.
The exclusive.
No way.
That is cool.
It's in DePaul. I always like to do this because it's easier to find the team if it's alphabetical.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
There you go, Brian.
I could put it back the other way.
No, you're fine. Look at that.
Sorry. Well, getting all up in your business.
You're fine. Justin, what was this? Orange? What is it?
Hobby exclusive.
There it is.
Yeah, baby.
It's a hobby exclusive parallel.
There we go. That's awesome. Sometimes you just gotta let the hobby mojo let it work its course. Brennan Davis. That's a cool card. Madrigal.
Yeah, it's definitely going to get the red box.
Definitely going to blow my paycheck. Prism.
Me too. I have a...
You're like, sorry, I didn't get paid this week, honey. We got robbed.
That's why I'm doing it before I get married.
Well, I mean, your situation is well established.
But now she's, now Morgan's is getting into cards. She almost bought one of those boxes.
Did you have C boxes?
Yeah. She goes, what are your thoughts on that? You seem like you really like that. I was like, honestly, there's one sitting on our kitchen counter because it said it got delivered. But I said, at
where'd
that price.
Get, where'd you get that one? Oh, you said Nate, right?
Yeah. Look at this little Alec Thomas with the Diamondbacks. But at that price that you had it at, I was like, honestly, that's going to be a $2,000 box probably in 3 months.
I took them down already.
Did you?
I just wanted to get Grizz and Noah and them a shot at it at a decent price.
Yeah. That was...
The rest of them can sit there until they get dusty.
Because I think they're going to hit 2K in about 2 or 3 months. Watch. It's one of those things.
I thought that, you know, they would have opened it like a couple hundred a box. Mm-hmm. And then tripled to quadrupled within 3 months. I didn't think they'd start out at where they started out at.
I don't think anyone did.
I was on Panini's website when they put it live to the public. And it was at $850, I think. And I couldn't get into the cart. And as I refreshed, it was instantly sold out. Instantly.
Yeah,
like, at $850?
Yeah. I had a feeling of what I was hearing.
No air young.
What I was hearing from people in the card world, the excitement plus the rarity, there's a lot of factors, and UFC's been getting a lot of good hype. I had a good feeling. I was like...
And it's still fresh in our heads what happens to the first year of prison.
Exactly.
You know,
even... In 2013,
prison
still
second year. Yep. I know, I was buying Brady's at the second year prison because they were like a dollar or two.
Ooh, I have Brady silvers.
That's huge, dude.
They're part of a set I built.
Yeah, you should take a look at it, see if, how clean they are. They, those are...
So they've been sitting in a binder since then.
Then you're golden. In all honesty,
they haven't even moved.
The during the documentary that they're about to have for them, that stuff's gonna be, oh, like it already is not cheap. Those silvers that you probably have.
I don't want to break up the set. Not like I'll be able to buy that one back cheaper at some point.
True, but you could use that to buy some UFC.
Yeah, but you sell the yep. I do like Tom Brady, too.
Do you?
He's one of my favorite football players.
That's cool.
He's Kevin Charles Woodson, if you can believe that.
Yeah, you told me that.
Charles Woodson, I get that one.
I mean, I just like competitors.
Well, then Woodson crosses out
the
NFL and becomes a Hall of Famer.
Yeah, there isn't a...
But here's the thing about Charles Woodson that's even harder. Is he went...
That's true.
That was like
double whammy.
Like, come back to Oakland.
Dude, that's like that's like Justin Fields for me now, because he went from Ohio State to the Bears. Like, it's fun.
Stop.
He's gonna just he's gonna torch my lines.
He was picked like right after Kobe.
Yeah, and wasn't that Randy
perfect.
Moss?
Perfect. Draft. Randy Moss's year.
Yep. Moss. And wasn't there... Yeah, it was those three big ones.
Yeah, he was picked right after Ryan Leaf, actually. Because they beat him first, then Ryan Leaf, then Woodson. Does that sound right? I always get him. It's either him from Brady or him.
Brady was 01. Or 2000.
Yeah.
Right? 2000.
I think he was Brady.
You know what? I'm starting to come around with these push style Sharpies.
These. I love them. Because
I hated them at first. I was like, I don't want to buy those. But Justin said he wanted them. So if you guys need it, then we'll get it.
Well, the reason why I like it is because if you put the cap on.
Yeah, you don't have to put the. It doesn't dry out on you.
Then, and sometimes the cap, the ink will get on the cap and then it gets on the. And then it gets all over you. When people used to send stuff for us to get autographed, like when fans like would send stuff in the mail, they would always send the push pens, push Sharpies, and that's when I got introduced. I was like, dude, I love these. Here you go, Brian.
Who are you?
Other Brian. You want to hold it up?
Yeah, baby.
I don't know if you wanted like a screenshot of this or.
Oh yeah, he's probably selling it right now.
He's selling it. Ooh, Jefferson Espinal for the Diamondbacks out of 250 purple auto. I like this kid. This is one of my guys on my list. For Frank. Frank, this is
Diamondbacks.
Yeah, that's a nice one.
Frankie.
Congrats, Frank. That's a nice one to have. Mike Trout.
Cool place, huh?
He just said, I don't think we were the only ones that felt this way about Trey.
Try. What do you got now? I thought you had a big one.
I was trying to adjust the camera. Espinal is very nice. I can't believe you pulled an orange Alcantara. That's
yeah, that's a good one.
That's like really good. Nice, Nick Allen. It's a 125.
Bowman's hard for me because I'm more of a rookie card logo kind of guy.
Yeah, it tops the flagship.
Yeah. But whatever, I get it. I've come around to it a lot. Like I used to just not even buy it.
Mm-hmm. That's what makes it fun though, because like you get preferences of that. Because I mean, there is no right or wrong. It's like, you know, the values based on what people want. So it's cool how there's two different crowds, and then some of the crowd bleeds together. Like for me, I will sell my Bowman first at debut, keep a few if the guy like is really good and I want to watch him, you know, after. But I usually sell enough to cut me even, so then the rest is just, yeah. But then if I sell and I like the guy and I'm watching the guy and I'm like, oh, this guy, you know, he's for real, then I'll go in and buy some of their flagship tops because it's cheaper. It's a cheaper buy-in. And it's easier to move liquidity-wise because it's a lower price point for people. Jordan Walker. I love like trying to figure out stuff like that.
I like figuring out these SSPs. I think this is the first Bowman SSP variation.
The one you made?
I didn't make this.
Which one?
What?
Like, this one. Look, it even says SSP underneath the first Bowman.
Can I see it? Oh, you made it, didn't you?
No, I did not. Look.
Get out of here.
Show him. Look.
Show him that.
Woo! Grizz and Brian, they're going to want one of those.
Well, I think it's like really SSSP.
Did you send that to the group chat?
Yeah.
Awesome.
Dude, I every time I see it.
You're either going to love or regret that one day.
Nah.
I won't regret it.
Well, I've got a plan.
With Will, you got to be careful. Will, like, he's like a secret, like a silent assassin.
Yeah.
He'll like hold on to cool, like funny stuff like that, and then out of nowhere he'll pop up, and you're like, oh, I forgot about that.
I am the same way.
Out of 250, Marlins.
I can't match this freaking shade of blue that they have going around the first one. I don't get it,
Here we go.
My wife woke up and she's like, are you okay? I woke up panicked. He's like, yeah, I'm great. Bears drafted the Buckeyes quarterback.
Did you really send that to her?
Yeah.
What'd she say?
Excellent.
Oh, that's
like,
funny.
Yeah, I'm going back to sleep now.
Dude, that really is like the perfect. That's like if the Lions drafted John Navarre and John Navarre was actually good. Like that, I feel like is equivalent to what just happened to you today.
I couldn't believe it. You guys said it was coming, and then I got like 7 text messages that said it was coming. I'm like, did it happen yet?
I can't believe they pulled off that trade. Like, no one thought they were going to be able to trade up because they didn't really have much to give. But they figured it out.
I am so stoked.
But I think you're right, dude. Like, honestly, like they had to, like they had to do that because.
It almost seems like they had this all planned out from the beginning.
Yeah, there's no way Andy Dalton was their solution.
Yeah, right? Like, really? I would have rather had Trubisky.
Yeah, me too.
He was improving.
Yeah, he was.
And cheaper.
Yeah.
They could have declined his option. Signed him for way less.
True. I mean, the Bills probably are giving him not much at all. I mean, why would you? Like, for a backup. Like, if you have Josh Allen.
I mean, now you've got 2 first-round quarterbacks from the same draft on the same team.
That's pretty cool.
That's wild.
No, Allen was 18. Biscuit was 17.
You're right.
Because Biscuit was with Mahomes. But, the Bills traded that pick to the Kansas City, that the 10th overall, to get Mahomes. The Bills traded to Kansas City that pick. And then the following year, they drafted Josh Allen. Remember how they went to the playoffs with Tyrod? And then Tyrod went to the Browns?
Yeah, they do.
Because Tyrod, they got to the playoffs off their awesome defense, and then Tyrod just, you know, great field general.
Shut down. I was at that game.
You were?
Yeah.
Dude, they should have beat the Patriots that year.
Oh, don't even go there.
Dude, Blake Bortles. Was...
Someone turn the lights off out there?
No, maybe just the alarm system.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know if I should put a hashtag on. Yeah, I should.
Wait.
Before no, make
you do that, let's look at what that brings up.
What?
The hashtag SSP.
True.
Great call. That's yeah, some weird, like, Nazi no, stuff or something.
True. It could be anything.
I know that's what you think it's for, but maybe somebody else thinks it's something.
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
People are changing words now.
True.
The meaning of words.
Like, when I say PSA around my parents, they think it's they like some prostate thing.
Like,
yeah, you know me.
Did anyone ever figure out what OPP stands for? Well, that's never been proven in WOBA.
He said WOBA.
Bro.
No, no, I'm talking about cats.
Well, that doesn't even make sense. Neither does the former, though, if you listen to the song. Why would people be walking around singing about that? Yeah, you know me.
You'd be surprised.
That doesn't make sense.
You'd be surprised these days.
Well, it's not. That was way back when.
Oh, was it? I don't know what you're talking about.
Early 90s.
Pass my time.
Years old.
Oh, that auto snuck up on me. Brendan McKay.
Are you in a hobby trance?
I didn't. Usually you can feel it, like it's a little bit thicker, or like, but it's one of the insert auto or insert autos, so it just kind of sneaks up on you.
Well, I'm gonna probably put this under the short print freaking hashtag. People be like, that's fake.
This is even better. This is for Kayla.
Kayla? Oh my god, that's awesome. She's been waiting for this break.
I know. Like, she's awesome.
Are we good? Is this it?
Yeah.
Is this it?
Kayla, congrats. This
is she awesome. In the room?
No. But I know she's going to watch it tomorrow, so this is even better because I'm going to be like, hey, have fun tomorrow watching this break.
Do you know her?
Uh huh.
You met her?
I've never met her, but she's big in the women's and sports cards for us. I have some really cool cards I need to send her that I showed her. Some like the old, you remember old school, like the women playing baseball? I forget the league's name.
Yeah. When everyone went to the war.
Yeah, so I found some.
Yeah,
what's the name of that movie?
That
was a great movie. Yeah. Gina Davis, Madonna, Rosie O'Donnell, the drunk Tom Hanks.
Yeah, he was funny.
Yeah. So a league of their own?
Yes. Yes. Yep, you got it.
You are your own soundboard. We don't need a soundboard. You're the soundboard.
It was so random, like out of nowhere.
That's my button. Don't push my button. The dude was like, I gotta see that. That's the way. We don't want the way. Short print. We could actually take over one of these hashtags.
Justin, you crack me up, dude. You crack me up. Wonder.
Tommy Harris.
Who's the Bears guy that they called the fridge?
William Perry.
They at the one of the sports card shops here, Showcase. Or what is it called?
Showtime.
Yeah, Showtime. We were there. Jimmy and I were there last time he was here. And they had a fridge in the back, and they had this huge poster of that guy, autographed. Jimmy tried to buy it, and they were like, no, that's not for sale. Jimmy's like, well, what's the price?
Oh, he's doing that thing.
Yeah, and they're like, it's just not. And he's like, come on. Like, it was.
The funny thing is he probably signed that for them for like $5.
Yeah, most likely.
It might have even come with the refrigerator.
It might, because
he had a sponsorship deal with, I think, Maytag back in the day.
That's awesome. But it really was, it was a really cool poster that's autographed in. It probably would have been, really cool in here.
I don't like him.
Really?
No. He stole Walter Payton's Super Bowl touchdown.
Oh. I don't really know anything about him besides his name's The Fridge. Which is pretty awesome.
If you watch the 30 for 30 out of the 85 Bears, it's, it's rough.
And he never got another
one. No, they could never get that.
It's just sad.
And by the time the organization made it back, he died.
Oh, that sucks. There's some product, I forget what it was, I think it was Leaf, where they had like the cut portrait or something that was autographed by him, but there was like thousands of them. And,
the calling cards?
No.
Are you talking about Walter Payton?
Yeah, I forget what it was. It's like, I don't know, like he must have did a signing for like 8x10s and then, but then they cut them up to put them in cards. I don't know, I see them all the time. I had a bunch of them at one time.
Pulled a, 101 Walter Payton cut auto out of NT.
Oh, that's cool.
J. Rich.
That's cool.
I was beat side by side. I could not do it.
That's so cool. Have you seen it since?
No.
It hasn't surfaced.
I think she still has it. You'll see her if you haven't already. It's on YouTube. It's Jennifer Rich. It's Jen Rich.
I'll ask her next time. See if she still has it. That's cool.
I could be wrong, but I think that it was her. The Bears in that
race. Oh, that just brings back. Justin, you're going to love this thing I'm bringing you tomorrow. Like, it's something that you might not even be able to sleep tomorrow once you get it.
Is it freaking Osceola's?
You're not going to be able to guess because I don't think you. Like, not a lot of people know that they're even. Like, they're even a thing. I know Brian does, just because of what he said just recently. I know who you'll know. Actually, I'm going to give Brian a clue. It has something to do with Flawless, and he's a big Florida State fan. And it's not cards. There's no... Oh, you're still working on yours?
But from what you're saying,
you know how Flawless sometimes they have.
I'm writing it down to show you. I don't want to ruin the surprise.
Yeah, that's the thing. Like a lot, like. I didn't even know it was really a thing until probably a couple years ago.
Oh my god, he's going to freak out.
It's going to go great on the wall. With all the other...
Does it involve a hot woman?
No.
I don't know, but by the time you get it, it probably will. You'll turn it into
it.
This is very intriguing.
You're going to like it.
You're going to name it Ginger. Oh, finally, Diamond King's truck list is out.
Nice. Who do we got in there?
I don't even know. Diamond King's checklist is always hard to read.
Mm-hmm.
Because, like, they don't there's 100 or there's 70 short prints out of a 170 card base set.
I don't know if they're considered the real short prints.
But they're not actually short printed, but like
they call them that.
They call them that.
Basically just like a variation. Carson Tucker?
The cuts checklist is great. Babe Ruth, Mickey Mantle, Frank Baker, Harmon Killebrew, Cool Papa Bell.
Ooh, another Jake Vogel.
Dude.
Auto for the Dodgers.
Cool Papa Bell would be awesome.
They do put some really cool stuff in there like that. Like the vintage stuff type.
I would freak out if they did like a Josh Gibson cut auto.
Oh, that would be so cool.
Dude, if I got a Nirvana CD signed by Kurt Cobain on it.
Those are not cheap.
I would probably poop an acorn.
That's on my list.
Really? Me too?
For,
which album cover? Not the one with the baby.
The one with the, my list is going to be, I'm going to start collecting records. And that's one of them I want to get. The one with the baby, because it's iconic.
Yeah.
You know, I mean,
do they have to put them in?
It literally just, why not?
Because it's like,
it's just a baby.
And you haven't seen the Whopper Hands for you.
It created a whole genre of music.
Dude. Not the album cover, the band did.
Yeah, but like that album was iconic.
Yeah, I know.
And
that was my.
I don't care if there's this fruit bottle on the cover.
I remember hearing it smelled like Teen Spirit for the first time. I was.
It sounded. I was. I'm not. I've never been a real big fan of Nirvana. But
yeah, dude.
Like
I became a fan hearing the song and like
it's just kind of crazy that these super like sad dudes
wander
created this crazy thing.
I had a poster of Kurt Cobain in my and I was pretty young for that for that time.
He always
the grunge look.
Yeah.
Flannels. Wrapped around your waist.
Never did that.
Oh God.
Did you guys?
No, I've
I had the flannel. I didn't wrap around my waist though. That was mainly for the girls.
That's it. It's funny because
remember the bongo shorts? Oh,
bongo shorts.
Yeah.
I don't remember those.
They're really short shorts.
Oh, my dad still wears those.
Used to be like. You guys come down past your fingertips.
Uh-uh. I don't remember that.
Clark Schmidt?
Oh, dude, the girls here in the middle. Oh, dressed nice.
Were they just girls' shorts?
They
or
were
everybody?
Very tight.
Ooh,
everybody.
Orange. Brennan Davis.
Ooh.
First
is
rounder.
Tom?
Is that another?
That is nice.
Tom's been waiting for that one.
Yep, it's Tom. Congrats, Tom. That's a nice one. I wonder where he. I think he'll start off in Double A, at least. Potentially.
He's so wiry.
Yeah.
He reminds me of a taller version of Alfonso Soriano.
Alfonso.
That corkscrew swing, just somehow made it look effortless.
Yeah.
But it's just all torque.
He was so good. He got paid. Remember that contract the Cubs gave him?
Oh my God. I was laughing.
Yeah.
Like, you guys are so stupid.
I had a jersey of him.
He was fun to watch.
Mm-hmm. He was funny. I met him when after he retired, like when I was still in the organization. We'd come by once in a while, random games. Nice guy.
Do you remember shortly after the Cubs got him... there are all of these reports and allegations of coming out about his age,
mm-hmm.
and that he was actually like 4 or 5 years older.
Mm-hmm. A lot of that. Francisco Liriano, too.
Yeah.
Yep.
I mean, it's pretty common, but when you get a contract like that...
To $199?
It's almost...
It's like...
It's fraud.
Do your homework.
It is. It, not
it's
only
fraud.
Is it fraud... fraud on like the highest level.
Yep.
I mean, is it their fault or is it the club's fault?
It's the player's fault. It's lying. It's fraud.
They're faking
gold. Grayson Rodriguez. The 50 for the Orioles.
It happened in the Little League World Series.
Yeah, when Pete Alonso was playing.
No, the bench warmers.
Remember?
Do you remember the movie?
I just remember
bench warmers.
Do you remember that one?
No, I've never seen
it. It's like a 20-year-old's pitching. It's one of the big actors, and he's Hispanic, and they show him the his birth certificate.
Yes,
it's a bottle of liquor.
It. Yeah.
20. And it's in crayon. I'm 13.
So there's not much different in the Diamond Kings set for autographs than there would be in anything else. I thought that, but I wanted to wait because sometimes they can do weird things with baseball because they can't have certain autographs of guys.
Oh, yeah.
Top signs, the top guys, once they get to, like, superstar status to exclusive. So, like, Mike Trout can't sign for Fernando Tatis, Francisco Lindor, like, all of those guys don't sign for...
Signed by...
Tatis. Oh. Yeah. Like, not until they're, but...
Star. Stardom.
Really onto something on top of that with their mini authentic relationships.
Me too.
But I don't know what they're doing with that right now. I know that that whole department was super crushed when Kobe died.
Yeah.
They were apparently incredibly close.
Interesting. I kind of briefly heard you say something today about Upper Deck.
Yeah.
What were you saying?
I'll tell you later.
Oh, okay. No context with it. I just thought the...
Not something I want to discuss on camera.
Gotcha. Yeah, Diamond... So when does that... Like, when can we officially... Diamond Kings? Like, when is it officially released?
I think it came out yesterday.
Did it? I didn't even know that.
So did UFC, but
a lot came out yesterday. Then
a lot of the distributors got their packages late. Not all of them, but and I think FedEx is still a little behind for that shooting. This guy is awesome. Have you ever watched his stuff on Facebook? He used to play football. Emmanuel Mancho. He's got the kind of mindset that you want, like, spreading throughout the world. He just gets it. Conor McGregor's got an Irish whiskey commercial.
He sold that company.
Yeah, that's where I was going with it. He just sold it for an absurd amount of money.
It was like $60 million, right?
Yeah, and the buyer was already someone that was invested in the company. They just wanted the majority share.
Yeah, makes sense. Or he wanted to make sure he didn't sell it to someone else that would have a majority share.
Yeah.
Sometimes that happens. And they leverage that, saying, well...
Yeah.
So basically, it's Connor's buddy.
That's what we did. Like a first try to recoup with it.
Yeah, first try. Yeah. Here we go. Look at this. This is a biggie. Maximo Acosta auto. $499. I was looking at these comps. This guy, people are going after. Big time.
Yeah, they cost a lot.
I mean, but what was the...
$300?
His autos, his base are going for way over that. I think.
And the spot price on the team is only $300.
Yeah, because then that's actually when I saw that, because I was doing my research today. Then you also got the Hernandez kid that is with the Rangers in this product, but he's with the technically with the Rays, like on the team of the Rays. His stuff isn't cheap either. So that caught my eye. I was like, well, that's a good buy. And I was going around trying to find some, but I think other people found them out before I did. I was like, darn.
Jordan Walker.
That's awesome. Maximum cast of Jordan Walker.
Well, that's a good proof of concept. Mm-hmm. Just means you had a good idea. You can use it. For other players.
Yep. I just caught it early, or too late. I'm always trying to, that's what I'm trying not to do. I'm trying to catch it early, but this time I couldn't.
Yeah.
I didn't think there'd be that much hype around him.
Who?
Maximo Acosta. He plays for the Rangers.
Nice.
I need to send you a link. There's a really nice write-up on some of these players.
Yeah.
And it's an easy read. Like, it's not like some of the reads, it's like so brutally, like brutal to read them all, but they do a nice job.
Knowing me, I'll start from the top and read all the way through to the bottom, like over time.
Really?
What?
Yeah.
I read base cards.
Yeah, that's what he said. He's like, I actually learned a lot just from reading the back of the Heritage base cards.
That is true, yeah.
Like,
I can see that.
That's right. They used to put tons of stuff on there.
Yeah.
I even learned some French.
Dude, on the Bowman. Back of the Bowman.
I didn't learn any French. That means we screwed up.
Back of Bowman, they do a really good job.
Yeah, I like them put like their interests on there.
Yeah. They'll be like, I remember I hit an auto, and it was
a hit an auto.
No, I hit an auto, and I didn't really know the guy. And I read the back; he was a valedictorian. I was like, oh, it had nothing about him being like an athlete or good at baseball. And I was like, probably not what the guy.
Collects Jordans.
Yeah. Like some of the guys would be like, oh, they got this award in high school or. It's 125 for the A's.
I've never
Justin Fields. Is he? He's not hurt, is he?
You never know what's going to happen.
True.
He's not currently hurt, but he's been painfully hurt in the last couple years. He played through it.
Yeah. I forgot about
showing. He's popped his nails. And he's got a. I forget what it is, but he's got a pretty severe. Medical condition. What is it called? When you have seizures all the time?
Epilepsy?
Yeah. I mean, there's. Somebody put on a bunch of reports that said he was epileptic.
Wow, that's unfortunate because.
Yeah.
Then you can't, like, drive and stuff.
Well, yeah. I mean, like. Probably shouldn't be getting your head bashed in.
That too.
You know, if you have a neurological problem
already.
Yeah. Maybe that's why he has like his the hair that he does to have extra.
That's your
padding. Yeah. I've always wondered that.
Yes.
They're making some new helmets though. Like, I forget
it's,
the.
I mean, it's cool that they're making these helmets safer, but it's not actually going to change it.
True.
Like, your head is still going very fast in a direction.
And the players are getting bigger and faster, like Jamin Davis.
Like, it's just. I don't care what you're wearing on your head, your brain's still going to move around.
True.
Hit harder.
Very true.
Or maybe it only moves a little bit, but then that happens a thousand times.
Mm-hmm. I agree.
Oh, nice guys.
That's why I would never want to be an NFL player. Except if he's like punter or something cool.
I played football. I don't know. My oldest son, I wouldn't let play. I'm not going to let my youngest son play.
Yeah.
Now, if they want to start when they're, you know, say a junior in high school, maybe.
Yeah. I had a buddy that did that, started in junior in high school, and he got a scholarship to college.
Yeah, I didn't start until I was a freshman, but I was also 5'4", 105 pounds when I was a freshman.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
They're like, I guess we can put you at corner, you're fast, but you barely even weigh enough to be on the field.
Yeah, and I forgot about the weights.
And then the next year, over the summer, I grew, I think I ended up at like 5'10", 155 pounds. So just over the summer, the coaches were like, oh my god, this is so awesome.
Well, I went from my freshman year being like a lineman, left tackle and all that, and I was a bigger kid, and I was supposed to be our starting center going into sophomore year, and then basically like I just started working out a ton, and I lost like 40 pounds.
Yeah.
And then they tried to keep me at center, and I was getting just demolished.
Thrown around.
They're like, Race, what happened to you? Like, I was like, I don't know. I started working out more and actually eating better. They're like, you're supposed to stay fat and be our center.
Yeah.
I was like, I don't want to tell you, man. They're like, okay, you're playing receiver now. I was like, oh, yes.
From offensive lineman to receiver.
Literally what happened. I was like, cool, I can just play run routes all day.
I don't have to get banged up every play.
Yeah. It sucked because when I was a freshman, remember that Iowa kid I was telling you about?
Yeah.
I was the only one that would team up against him because no one else would want to go against him. And I was like, I'll do it. And I would just get demolished. And I was like, I never have to do that again.
Yeah, I didn't. I always wanted the best player.
Yeah.
I am going to get him. Shut him down.
Oh, he would toss me around. It sucked.
Going to violently run into anybody.
It's the Martin. Austin Martin. This is random, but you know Rolls Royce?
Yeah.
They build stuff for our submarines.
Oh, they do?
Yeah.
I knew they had to do something more than just make those fancy cars.
Yep. I learned that. Every time I see Austin Martin, I'm thinking of car.
Oh, yeah. They're so heavy, though.
Mm-hmm.
They probably get, like, 5 miles a gallon.
But the control on them, because they're heavy, would be insane.
Yeah. Tom Brady's one of their sponsors.
Who?
Austin Martin.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I didn't know that. J. Dom?
Yeah.
What's up, R2?
All of his sponsorship deals are very unique.
Yeah. Well, so here, okay.
Very carefully picked.
I like you said that. So I invested in Arm & Armor back in like 2009.
Yeah.
And the whole reason why I invested in it because I read something where Tom Brady also took an endorsement deal for Arm & Armor, but instead of getting paid, he wanted to get paid in equity.
Oh, yeah.
So when I saw that, because they were still growing, and I saw they were growing in baseball pretty well because I was seeing it a lot, and I was like, that's a whole market they can take advantage of. But then I saw that Tom Brady was going to come on, and he was believing in it where you wanted equity. I said, he does it. Ooh, look at this cool auto. Brady and Carcion to 1 cent or to 75 for the Marlins. And that's what Brady does, though. Like, he picks, he's very strategic with his endorsements, and he usually wants equity more. Like, he doesn't necessarily want cash, which is just awesome, because then he's invested in the, like, he has skin in the game to make it even, to do even more than what, you know, your normal endorsee would do.
Bill Belichick said that usually they're just not very interested in the first round of the draft. During his interview, he's like, I don't know. Usually we're just not very interested in the first round of the draft.
He's so awesome.
He's not human.
I just appreciate his honesty.
Yeah.
Like
I could be using this time to devise an evil plan against all offenses.
What in the world?
You hit that stand button.
Oh. Press back. I was like, is that Bill part? Because you said right when he was going to take over the world, I was like. Sorry. We had a stand up desk start standing up on its own. R2, how you doing, man? We ripping. Nick Gonzalez out of 499. It's crazy what Under Armour has done the last 20 years.
Oh, you went to the cut. Dolphins.
Blue, O'Neal Cruz. Royce Lewis. I remember we were doing trivia, like one of the first times I was here live with you.
Yeah.
Who was doing the trivia? Because I was sleeping.
Zinda.
Yeah.
I think you would dig his Twitter.
Yeah, I needed to. We need to get him back on here because that was so much fun. I was really enjoying that.
He doesn't like Bowman.
He doesn't like Bowman?
No, he likes the dead players.
Oh, yeah. Because he's the...
Yeah.
Worked at the Cooperstown?
Yeah, I always thought he was a really good guy. Maybe he's not a guy at all. But, he's younger than I am. I'm like, that's interesting. How do you know all this old shit? Like, what sparks your interest in that?
Yeah.
It's not common.
Honestly, that's how I started off, was I honestly knew all the old guys. I wasn't really, like, I knew the current players, but I knew more that I really don't know much now, because everything's all current players, everything. But when I first started collecting, I was more into vintage than anything. I still love vintage now, it's just
so hard. I don't know anything about it.
Yeah. You know? Scary because it's
like
expensive.
Third year card, second year card, OC, not OC, but like all of that stuff. It's not my wheelhouse.
Yeah. Here we go. Second to last box.
Break guy, like they only do like vintage pack breaks. I think it's called like Rip It or something like that. They have cool ads.
Yeah. GGG money.
I really appreciate when people come in, but they do something different that not everybody else is doing already.
Yeah. Well, that makes sense why he was in, like, he was on our live for Heritage, if he likes the older stuff.
Yep.
We haven't seen him since.
Archives, like,
that's cool.
The actual Topps products, usually, not Bowman.
Like Series 1 and stuff?
Yeah, a little bit. Like Archives and...
How do you do Series 1? Do you do teams? Because I feel like the sorting would be nuts.
That one's not fun, man.
You almost would have to do, like, it's division.
It's not fun at all.
Yeah, I don't know. That one seems rough.
So basically, I'll open it all, do a recap after I'm done of, like, the super notable stuff, and then I don't separate anything until I'm sorting and sit down, and I go through the whole stack and pick out all the SPs and rookies and variations and make sure there's actually more of those than the hard base cards.
Nuts.
But still, you're saving a shitload of weight and probably another hour sorting.
Oh, no doubt, dude. No doubt. Because I was just thinking, I was like, man, dude, that stuff.
Like, that stuff's just, like, time.
Yeah.
Consuming. It's not hard. Like, the college products, or the non-licensed products.
Oh, yeah.
Are really difficult.
Can only imagine.
Like, all these football cards that are going to come out now from the draft, they'll all be in their college uniforms. Like Leaf. So you have to go to the checklist afterwards to make sure, like, nobody's going to memorize all of these guys and what team they are on. So then you got to go back and you're like, okay, well, who does Elijah Vera Tucker play for?
Mm-hmm.
You know where Justin Fields and Trevor Lawrence go, but.
Yeah, that's tough. Yeah, UFC is pricey. I think it's... Have you seen it rip, though, GG Money? It's some good stuff. Color, at least. A lot of color.
You didn't.
I think it's just going to keep on climbing. I really don't think they made a lot of it. I don't think they
had enough time to make a lot of it.
True. And I bet they were like, man, if we don't make a lot of it, high price point, we don't really know what the market's going to be like.
Yep. So let's start with Prism and make it amazing.
Uh-huh.
And then we can go back and make, like, flagship Donruss or whatever.
Yeah. Bobby Dalbec. They're setting their hook.
Well, they used their good hook.
Yeah. They're smart. Antonio Gomez. That's a nice one for the Yanks. Yep. Panini has UFC. Wonder. That's a cool picture.
Yeah.
I like that.
Is that the one with two bats?
Yeah.
I'm just sitting there thinking to myself, now what do you need two bats for at the same time? If anything, I feel like that would hold you back.
This baseball season's already been great. All these great rookies that are sitting waiting to get called up. This season's gonna be.
When does that happen?
I forget the exact time frame, but there's a time where they have to...
Service time is up.
Yeah, they can't call them up too early.
Yeah, because then they have to pay them.
Yep.
That's so dirty.
I know, it's the worst. Kalenic spoke on.
Best player on the field.
Here's our auto. Hero Pomeranz for the Giants. He's the one with the crazy signature.
Do you know when their next collective bargaining agreement is?
I believe in a year, it's either not. I think it's either this upcoming season or the season after that.
I bet if they don't change that, there'll be a strike.
There's gonna be a lot. I've already been hearing.
And then there's that weird thing that they're doing with the off season and like. It almost seems like collusion that all the teams are waiting till such a late date to sign guys.
Oh, it is. So remember the year JD Martinez was a free agent and before he went to the Red Sox? That was the season where they had it was a thing where all the owners that's why JD could barely get a job even though he was incredible
I knew it. Those guys are.
Oh, dude, they're. Baseball, there's so many. It's so in like so depth. There's so much stuff going on in baseball that people like. It's hard to see from the outside. Daniel Espinosa, and that's why like we see more veteran players now not being able to get a contract more than ever to $299.
Well, I've never been a big believer in getting paid for what you already did.
I agree.
Contract versus. Getting paid for what you're
Josiah Gray
able to do.
But even like the not the big stars, but just like the regular veterans that are going to be on, you know, not crazy contracts.
Yeah. Okay. I know what you mean.
Something about because you got to pay their service time, like, and there's fees that go in it for the owners, like pension, like we get pensions and stuff, and that's why it's easier just to have a guy on a rookie contract, because it's considerably like a lot less
way
expensive.
Way cheaper. There's lower minimums, right? Like you have to make you get a larger base pay for X amount of years in the league.
Not the base pay is straight across the board, but so this is what it was back when I was in 2014. This is the last time I read about it. So when I was in with the Diamondbacks, when you had to have, I forget how many days, 45 days of service time in the league, and then you get your pension at 65, and it starts off like. You get like 40 or like 35 grand a year for your pension. After every 10 days of your service time, you get like an extra, I don't know what it is, like a couple hundred dollars on your pension a year, if that makes sense. If I'm saying it right. So like every 10 days. So like you have these guys, you know, the veteran players that kind of stick around, like a Jay Bruce who just retired. This year, halfway through, or not even halfway through, he was with the Yankees. But he's been around forever. Or yeah, he might not have had a big contract.
But it cost them a ton of money.
Yeah, other ways. So there's so many factors like that. That's why you get the Rays and stuff. Like, they just can't afford it. To even sign... Like, they'll sign those kind of guys, but they...
That makes way more sense.
There's just so many factors, more than just the huge, like the Mookie Betts contracts. There's way more layers to it. Ooh, that's a thick one. Here's the last box, everyone. Last box.
Hey, Justin.
So, which I can get more of those boxes ready since now, like I can use that one, and which I'm excited about. It's gonna take a while for them to upload all those.
Yeah.
But when they do, dude, it's gonna be so much fun watching it. Just like they're gonna sell like crazy.
There's a lot of great COMC stuff in there.
Yeah. I agree. Like stuff that will just fly off the shelves at COMC.
Do you do any like quick math in your head when you're going through it to be like, all right, well, on average, this box would yield like maybe $3 a card or something like that?
I don't do it by box. I just do when I'm looking at it. Like I can usually tell the values of the card pretty quickly, like just without having to necessarily look it up. Or, you know, there's not every card will be, I'll be right on it, but I have, like, a good idea of, oh, this card should be sent there, or who these cards shouldn't, for it to make sense. But those boxes, ooh, look at this. So the last box, Austin Hendrick Auto to 100.
Nice.
That is a nice one. This kid is going to be. He's going to be fun to watch.
He's got the Reds.
Yeah, who we got? Who we got? Robert. Robert Boyce. Another thing about COMC, like, there'll be a card where you're like, oh, this card's like only worth a dollar or two, and then you put it on COMC, you're like, holy crap, it's like a $20 card.
It's a different marketplace.
Uh huh.
Some cards just, you could put a card on eBay and it would never sell. Exactly. You could put it on COMC, it would sell in a second.
Exactly.
You look for a card on there and you see it and you're like, what? I don't want to pay $30 for a Marion Lutz card. Like,
that's nice. 75. Exactly. So that's why I like, because there's stuff in there where it's like, you know what? This could be anywhere from $1 to $50. This one card. But it kind of does the research for you, too, because it shows you, like, what the lowest price is.
Yeah.
So it kind of does the research for you, too.
Yeah, you don't have to pay for that extra content.
Yeah.
I haven't said anything. I was kind of pissed off. So, I sent him a not real nice message, and they replied nicely and said, we'll send your stuff up in the next couple weeks here instead. Just so you know, going forward, we're not processing stuff for at least this amount of days. And I was like, well, that's great. Thank you for doing that. But when I sent these, you didn't have that disclaimer up.
Exactly.
You changed it in the middle.
Like, you still have to meet that commitment.
Yeah.
Or do something different. Like, you took my money.
Exactly. I probably sent those same emails, dude. Andrew Vaughn Gold. This is a nice one.
That's yes, a sir.
Cool insert. This kid's going to hit. Just wait till it gets warm out. That ball will fly.
Oh, yeah.
I'm not worried about him. He hasn't been as hot as people thought he was going to be to start the season, but he's going to, overall, it'll all balance out for him. He's consistent.
You got to get used to playing that corner, too.
Yeah. Switching defense.
That's not, I mean, one, you're a rookie, and because you've showed success in hitting the ball, you're now expected to come up and perform like an all-star.
And learn a new position.
And the hardest thing in sports to do. And learn a new position.
That's why Nick Cassiano struggled in the beginning for the Tigers, because they kept switching him.
Yeah, he was what? He started at third base?
Yeah. Gilbert Sanchez
started, and then they moved him to the corners.
Yep. Man, watching him, I used to. Oh man.
He's hot now. He's having a good year.
He You should see the stacks I have of him.
I didn't understand why he got kicked out.
No one does. It's baseball tries to reduce the fun.
Did you see the ejection the other day of the coach?
No, which one?
So he goes out to challenge his play, like,
ooh, this is a nice one.
So there's just a dribbler to the pitcher, and the pitcher kind of runs over and tosses it to the first baseman. The runner's running by the pitcher, is like,
mm-hmm.
you know, after he tossed it to finish running it out. And, they instead called him safe, and the ref or the ump just walked away, like, you know, no big deal or anything. And the coach comes up and he's like, what the hell are you talking about? And then he kicks the coach out right away. It turns out that his interpretation of the play with the pitcher being in the vicinity of the runner that he was blocking the base path, so he called him safe.
I just hate how umps throw coaches out quickly.
Yeah.
It's
like you're supposed to have, he's coming out to talk to you, have a conversation.
Like, you're not bigger than the game, is what I used to always tell the umps. Like, you throwing out someone makes it, you're bigger than the game.
You're supposed to be in control, so
yeah.
Get it in control before you try to just remove someone.
Exactly. All right, let's do a little recap here. That was fun. So this is a little hobby case, Bowman. So I'll just run through these. Got some nice ones. This was another nice case. That's a nice auto. That is an awesome auto. Old Jake Vogel. Here's some autos. This kid's going to be good. Little Nick Madrigal. White Sox had a great break. Alexander Vargas. Angel Martinez. Austin Cox. Nick Mattin. Brendan McKay for Kayla. And Andrew Vaughn. And that's our break. And I think we got, Brian, are we doing another one?
I'm going to do a jumbo right after this.
Perfect. We're going to do a jumbo right after this.
And then we're